Good day. Thank you all for tuning in. My name is Casimir Koolman, and I will tell you more about our layout module of Pi-S, which is being used for the design of the compartments and creating the internal geometry of a vessel. So, first of all, what are the main advantages of layout compared to other software packages? We offer a flexible tool to manage spaces, planes, and addresses the duality between them. Compartments can be created by defining bulkheads and decks and cutting the vessel in smaller pieces. Later on, you can combine those pieces together into one bigger compartment. Bulkheads and decks can also be defined by user-defined coordinates. And besides that, we recently have integrated a piping system and for the design and modeling. And this is also a strong point of us. So, what's layout? This is our graphical user interface of layout. On the left top corner, you see the 3D model. On the bottom, you see the cross section, horizontal section, and the longitudinal sections of all the compartments with the different colors. And on the right top, you see the compartment tree and the physical planes. As you can see, a lot of planes has been added, but and to create a lot of subcompartments. And those subcompartments have been combined together to one compartment, and this is the vessel which has been defined. So, what's new? Recently, the data storage of the physical planes has been enhanced to include a specific weight. This is used in a new feature labeled area table, which includes of each plane its area, center of gravity, and weight. At the end of the table, as you can see here, the total weight and the center of gravity has been listed. But when designing or defining a vessel, for some tanks or compartments, target capacities apply. In those cases, it will be convenient to have a permanent feedback on actual volume of the compartment. This feature is now available in the layout module and can be seen on the right top of this screen. So you see the compartment volume of this exact compartment. But we also added a new setting, which commands the tank data to be computed directly, exactly from the given weight or filling percentage. In this mode, the computational results are for actual trim, heel, and tank geometry, and may hence deviate from interpolated results, which could be subject to interpolation inaccuracies. And next to that, we recently added the piping. So we implemented piping in this module. With this, we have the integrated bulkhead and deck, and the pipe modeling, of course. With those pipes, you can see the effects which the pipes have on the damage stability. Piping data can be exchanged with other engineering software. I will tell you more about this later on. It's the Kinematic software. And we have time domain damage stability analysis. And how does it look like in our layout module? Well, this is one example of one piping. You can see all the connections, what those connections are, and where they connected with. And in this way, you can implement the entire piping in the vessel, and later on, you can calculate the damage stability of the vessel and what's the effect of those piping in this damage stability. And last but not least, we have our interface with Kinematic Hull. Time-consuming design data exchanges and managing the consistency of design data are designers' main challenges. Therefore, a uniform and modern data exchanges interface between early design software tools and steel design software tools are very beneficial. With the focus on bulkheads and decks, compartments and piping, which I just told you, we created an implementation which covers intensively used data and actions, as well as the comprehensive manual and other instruction materials. So what do we have? It's a two-way 3D connection with Cadmatic Hull and BIAS, of course. You can communicate the design changes. And we try to make this as user-friendly as possible. How does it look like? This is a screenshot. On the left, you see our layout module. And on the right, you see the Cadmatic e-browser of the exact same vessel. And I will now, if I can do that, show you a live demonstration. So this is Cadmatic Hull. Let me see, and I've already opened the vessel. Next to it, I opened our layout module. And let's say I want to add a physical plane, let's say a transverse bulkhead at frame 118. So here in the front, I will call it, let's say, example Cadmatic. I'm saying yes, and I don't want the entire vessel to have a physical plane, only the bottom, and to continue. And now here, this plane has been added, and now there are two sub-compartments new. Here you can see the name, example Cadmatic of the physical plane. But now I want to have this exact same plane also in Cadmatic. So then I go, oh, this is the Hull viewer. I go back to Cadmatic. That was too fast. First of all, you have to go to layout and put on the server mode. So now the server mode is on, and he can send data to Cadmatic. In Cadmatic, I say, okay, let's do design data and get design data. So from BIAS to Cadmatic. And now it's processing. Here you see a complete list of all the planes which are available in Cadmatic already, or which are new and could be imported from BIAS. And on the down here you see example Cadmatic. So this is the plane I just created in BIAS, and now it has been transferred to Cadmatic. Of course, I have to click on apply to local system, so I only want to have to apply this physical plane to the system. Now it's Cadmatic is recalculating all of the information, and now the plane has been added. Here you can see it, it's not new already, it's identical, has been added to the model in Cadmatic. But it also works the other way around. To be honest, I've made a short video about this, which I want to show you. Let me see, then I'm going to go to the next slide. This is a short video about how it's going from BIAS to Cadmatic and the other way around. And I will guide you through it. So we have two windows open, so one for layout and one for Cadmatic Hull Viewer. Those are the exact same models. They're already fully synchronized, as you can see. But we want to show how the connection is working. So we want to add a plane in layout, so which I've done previously, but now in the movie. So apparently he wants to double check, to check the double bottom capacity. And then he's previewing to clipboard the maximum tank volume tables. And apparently he thinks the capacity is not sufficient. So, which means he has to make the tank larger. So he's going back to the layout, to the graphical user interface. He's clicking on the tank top and he's saying, okay, well, I want to change it. I don't want to have it at 0.18, but at 1.5. So now I'm changing the tank top to 1.5 meters. Then I will recheck the ballast capacity if it's still what I want it to be. And yes, it's bigger now. So I want to keep this change which I've done to the tank top. but I also want to transfer this data back to Cadmatic because I'm deciding, okay, well, I want to have this tank top in this way, and instead of modifying it the exact same in Cadmatic Hull, you are trying to get this information with the interface, so that you don't have to modify it again, but that you want to change it. So now here there's the exact same list of all the references, and here I'm selecting the tank top because that's the only one I want to change, because that's the one for the ballast capacity. And then I say apply to local system, and then Cadmatic is calculating again to get this same exact change within Cadmatic and see how the what would change for the other planes. So now I will take a look in Cadmatic to the 3D model in Hull Viewer. It's calculating, it's still calculating the parts together. And as you can see, the tank top has been shifted to 1.5 meters, which was the exact same change I've done in Pius. And now I want to have this change also to the other planes. So he's going to recalculate all the construction parts, so it's correct. And indeed, this is automated in the future. This is an old video. Currently, this has been automated. So at this moment, you don't have to recalculate all the related parts anymore. So now it's going back to Cadmatic for the recalculation of all the other parts. So now it was small, but you didn't see it exactly. But now the parts have been recalculated, and now they all line up again. So the change of the tank top, which has been done in Pius, has been transferred to the interface to Cadmatic. But yeah, of course, I also want to do it the other way. I mean, we already said it was a two-way connection. So you've seen it worked from Pius to Cadmatic to get, in the case of the video, to get a tank top to 1.5 meters. And in my case, to get a complete new plane. And now we're going to show you the other way. So we opened the Cadmatic Hull software of the exact same vessel, of course. He will add a rectangular to make it look like an engine, because the engine has to be in the engine room, and they want sufficient space between the engine and the bulkhead. So this should be the engine, the dummy engine, of course, and the distance has to be sufficient to the bulkhead in front. So this means he wants to move the bulkhead a bit. So he's clicking on the action button for in Cadmatic to move this bulkhead. So he wants to shift it at let's say 2 meters. First, of course, a preview, otherwise it's too fast. And then it's recalculating again, like we've seen in the other part of the movie. So he's now shifting the bulkhead of the engine room 2 meters to the front. And as you can see, it's taking taking some time. It's a it's a big model, and a lot of other parts are depending on this part. So he has to calculate all his movements. And as you can see, the bulkhead has been shifted. So this is all done in Chematic. But we also want to have this change in layout. So then he's opening the layout server. This server is needed to get these exact changes from Chematic to BIAS. So the server has been opened. We go back to layout. And then again, we will click on collaborate, but not on server mode, but on exchange. And now layout is asking to Chematic, you know, what has been changed? What planes do we already have in common? Are identical, which are not? So this is the complete list again of all of the names of the planes, and if they are changed, yes or no, and if they are changed, when they are changed. So all of this data is over here. Here you see the tank top again, which we changed in Pius and which has been changed to Chematic. But we are not looking for the tank top, we are looking for the engine room bulkhead, because that one has been changed in Chematic and we want to change it back to Pius as well. Where's my mouse? Apparently it was too fast. Well, the other way, I have the video over here. Short moment, please. Chematic video. So the last part wasn't in it. Sorry for that. So that's again the tank top again we already had, but we only want the engine room bulkhead to change. As you can see, it's pause it. We didn't change it, and at the Chematic part, it has been changed. It's in Dutch, but of course we currently have an English version. We already selected only the engine room bulkhead to yes to synchronize. Then we click on then we want to click on apply changes, and as you can see here, this will change, and plop, the change which we had done in Chematic also changed in Pius now. So that's that part about the connection with Chematic. So as you have seen, it's a two-way connection. We've changed something in Pius, and it's and we transferred this information to Chematic. And the other way around, we changed the engine room bulkhead in Chematic. We went back to Pius and we applied those changes to the local system of Pius. And this, in this video and in what I've shown you, it has been done on one computer, but both computers doesn't have to be at the same place. So if you are, let's say, we're currently in the Netherlands, so I'm currently working in on layout on this model, but someone is in Poland working on the Chematic part, and he can also get the exact data from my Pius file to his Chematic file through this connection. Okay, so that's the connection between them. And I think that's already it. So I've showed you the recent and future developments of our layout module. And the biggest part, of course, went about the connection with Cabmatic, which I think is really, really usable. And I hope you can use them. You can use it as well in the future, because it will save a lot of time. I don't know if there are any questions or from your side, or if you don't have questions now, just ask them by calling us or sending us an email. It shouldn't be a problem. And next week, I believe the last seminar already will be done by my colleague Bart again. It will be on Thursday, August 20th at 1400 hours Central Eastern Time. And this will be about loading and our recent and future developments. So I want to thank you all for tuning in, maybe on a later stage. Thank you all, and if you have questions, please let us know by phone or calling, or put a comment underneath this video. So thank you again, and have a great day.